Hey guys, welcome back to Oxygen Not Included, Klei's amazing space colony simulator extraordinaire. My name is Twitchi, and we are in the Rockefeller Brains, a collection... No, hit the wrong button. A collection of asteroids out in the wilds of space, where we have a collection of mostly physicists inside this place. Last time, I built myself a little bit of geothermal power off of this minor volcano, but unfortunately, it has a few flaws, mostly to do with the way these doors are laid out. At the moment, lava will roll in through these holes here and collect in this bottom area where the doors will shut and this one will open up. Unfortunately, there will be too much lava to be contained by this single tile down below, and then it will spill back up, making thermal contact with this door, and it sucks all the heat out of all the lava, and then we get all sorts of troubles with materials being built up down below. So we need to fix that, and I am going to see if I can't fix that without actually trying not to step foot in there. It's very hot. There's 2,000 degree stuff in there. There's 180 degree stuff over here. If I could avoid getting into either of them, that would be fine, but I'm almost certain I'm going to have to go into the steam room to try and turn this door around to fit into this space. But I'm gonna try and where is Franklin right now? She should be coming along to open all of this up. Yep, brilliant, wonderful. I'm gonna try and deconstruct this door, turn it around this way, and then kind of build these walls down a little bit further, preserving the vacuum inside and the steam over this side. Franklin, where are you? I would really like this done now, thank you. You know what, we've only got a limited amount of time to get this done. This volcano will become active again in 13 cycles, so get used to the sound of the alarm, because it's going to be there for a while. It's definitely going to be there for a while. So you might ask, as I can destroy this door from here, and in fact I know that I can build it again from this side as well, why am I bothering to build this doorway down? Well, you can see the answer right here. There's a bit of an automation signal that needs to pass in that direction rather than the straight down as it is, and I cannot reach that from here. So I need to now build up all of these tiles to be able to reach down into this corner. In fact, I can't put that door there because we also need to put a tile on top of that. Research though, what was this? Automation. Beautiful. I forgot I'd even queued that up. All right, Franklin, come along, do the job. Thank you very much. We're just gonna corner build our way piece by piece, block by block, or tile by tile, I suppose. In fact, I'm wondering if I cannot build these sides as well. This would make it so that I could actually just get all the way down and then corner build the door without actually having to let the gases in, and then I just build my way back up in the same manner. I think we might be able to do that. Hopefully no gases will get locked in there at the same time. That really is my big worry, is that we end up with a whole bunch of weird gases stuck inside. Oxygen, it would be pretty bad, to be honest, though I do need to get a better gas under here. I forgot about that from last time. We could just get a little bit of hydrogen to conduct the heat from this tungsten tile to the thermosensor. That would be ideal. Oh, this just every step along the way feels super, super scary, but hopefully we will be fine. I'm even gonna hit red alert if we need to. We will go through the night working these duplicants to the very end of their beings if we have to, just to make sure this works fine. I now need to think about what needs to happen next. The more I'm looking at this, the more I am not sure we're going to be able to get in at the angle that I want to. So I'm going to build a bunch of ladders underneath, still really trying to avoid busting in through this way, which would be the easy answer, you know. Oh, somehow they can reach it from up there. Okay, I mean, that's fine. Can you then also put this in place from up there? I mean, nighttime's been cool, so I'm not expecting... All right, we're not going to go to red alert because I feel confident in what's going on here. Okay, the morning has come. Franklin's come along and put this mechanical airlock in the right orientation here. Right, I like that, and we are connected to the correct automation. A little bit worried about the fact that there's two tiles here. I would have preferred one, but my Mobo Miner can dig both, and that means that everything will fall down into the range of the auto sweeper here. So actually, I think we're doing okay. Oh, trying to take things apart in the right order. Definitely the problem we've got here. Okay, my big concern now is whether we can reach that door or not. That is by far my biggest. Yeah, okay, looks like we should be okay. Looks like we should be fine. Let's also, whilst we're at this, can we get the obsidian taken out of there? Would that be a thing that can happen? Beautiful. Also, there's steel in there. I would like to get rid of that. No, manufactured material. Everything gray is not the same thing. All right, cool. That's everything out. This guy... Let's see if we can sweep it. That might be the way we do it. Okay, new form factor achieved. Actually, you know what? I like this. I like this a lot. I'm definitely going to fill this tile in, but I think we're there. I think we've got the situation we set out to achieve. I do like these first sections that go as well as I planned them to go. That's great. Ooh, I can, however, see one issue we're going to have to try and overcome, and I think I'm going to try and do it like this. I'm going to put an auto sweeper there. I'm going to put down... Actually, I want to put this auto sweeper one lower. Let me just correct that. Let's try it back there, actually. The reason that I want to put this here is, of course... Oh, look at that. Because I want to get these parts in here. Look at all this debris. I'm not so worried about the obsidian, but I am worried about the 1.3 tons of not very hot igneous rock here. I mean, I say it's not very hot. This is all very relative right now, because it's 1,400 degrees C. It would melt any one of my duplicates. It wouldn't actually melt. You got to get up to 9,000 to melt a duplicate. But it would kill any one of my duplicates. So trying to not let that happen. The magma is going to be coming out at 1700. I believe it melts. Let's have a look at the 1409. Is this actually hot enough? Well, it's only 1 degree down. Maybe it could be fine. But no, we're not going to do that. So I'm going to leave that running in the background because I have a bit of another issue. Let's come over. No, not over here. Over to here. You might notice that our food is running down. The power is out across here. What's going on? I've got a bit of a heat issue here, and what the actual problem is, so people can't get in and turn things over, the atmosphere suits have died, power, this battery has died, things have gone wrong over here, and I kind of need to fix them, and the only way I can really fix them is to rip this thing apart. So what's been going on is I was expecting to use more steel. I was really expecting to have the drill cone at some point in the future. I got distracted. You know me, that's how it works. So I'm going to now do that, but I need to figure out all of the rocket infrastructure if we are going to be able to make things very efficient here. So I'm going to move I'm going to move this gas reservoir under here. We're going to put a steam turbine on the top of this steam box so we can continue cooling this area down, but I feel like this area here would be good for that. And to do that, I am going to bust a hole in the side. I was thinking about trying to pump it all out via the magic of this pump over here. No, we're just gonna rip a hole in the side and we'll deal with it like that. I actually want to come through. We're gonna rip everything down. There are definitely gonna be some consequences to that action, but we're gonna do it anyway. Where is Curie off to? I was expecting to come along and do some stuff. Use the wall toilet. No. What is it? We click here and grounded. Yes, don't be using the toilets in here. Thank you very much. You got your own toilet. Oh no. I mean, okay, maybe we will let them use the ones in here for now until we can get all of that fixed. Yes. Okay, this one's not coming together quite as quick as I would have liked, but hopefully putting this door in place is going to mean that we are not going to absolutely fry all our duplicants when we open up this deconstruction pit here. Curie loves to dig. I'm not sure if I've mentioned this to you. She would take digging over deconstruction almost every time, it turns out. All right, here we go. Gonna get some of the wires taken out. Okay, that's fine. What I really want to know is what's gonna happen to all this steam. There we go. It is off and it is away. I'm hoping that it just pushes its way up and out. If Curie, you know what? I'm gonna just quickly cancel all of these jobs because you know what? She doesn't need to be here right now. Let's get her out of there. Curie, please. I'm also gonna turn off moving position permissions for all of them. I think that'd be a good way of, yeah, there we go. All right, now we just let this drift out of here. That's fine. We're already down to like single digits of kilos. This is good. So the vacuum seems to be making its way back down this tube easy enough. I don't know whether that's because all the water is just condensing out. That might be a problem, especially as this door is now 70 odd degrees. We definitely need to get this all down quite low so we don't melt the material underneath. I wonder where we can dig over this way just to get rid of the water. Obviously I would prefer just to mop it up, but you know, we deal with what we can. Even at regular speed, I can literally just sit here and watch the gram value for the steam countdown. This is good. This is good. I'm still a little bit worried about the water, but that's fine. In fact, I'm going to come along here and I'm going to set all this to deconstruct. 73 degrees. Have we got stuff made out of lead down here? There's a few things made out of lead. There's one thing made out of lead. Okay, I think we're fine with that. I might just let them through. Okay, go, Curie, go. But at the same time, I'm going to start a little mop order here. Okay, it is indeed scolding for Curie, but that's okay. I think she'll live. I think she'll survive. The water is being picked up. The gas is escaping its way out there. We're down to... Well, there's hundreds of grams there. Why have we got hundreds of grams everywhere now? Maybe I was reading kilograms when I meant grams. Oh, well. I've just found out why we have gas turning to... turning to gas in here. We need to take apart these pipes as quick as possible. Unfortunately, Curie is going to take a lot of damage doing that. I wonder if we've got a triage cot set up anymore? I don't know. The water definitely not helping. Keep an eye on Curie. Okay, let's move her down here for now. Unfortunately, because the alarm is going, even if I try and put her into the cot that I've got over here, she's not going to get into it until these jobs are done. Hopefully Maxwell can take over though. We'll take that. But this doesn't need to be doing. Let's put that to a 5 and let's study what we need to actually take out here. Actually, I think we're fine. I think we're fine as long as these things get taken away nicely. All right, beautiful. Good. Oh, Curie's gonna have... She came up here to go to the toilet. I do hope she's not gonna go through anything hot. Why are you just hanging out there? Go back to the... Oh, she's gonna have trouble. She's gonna have a bad time. Oh no! All right, she's fine. Please get back to the hospital, please. Oh, things are getting hot all over the place and breaking. Let's see if we can fix some of them. But man, that's not ideal. Yeah, we got a little bit of iron. That would be good. Okay, well, whilst this is in the process of going horrifically, let's go over and have a look over this side. I was kind of hoping these guys would have done this little set of jobs by now. Let's see if we can't get them moving on a little bit better, because I want to see whether this auto sweeper can actually get through this block here, this little one tile gap. I'm probably gonna actually end up destroying the auto sweeper and building it several times over. Where is Franklin? She's the only one who can actually build the auto sweeper itself. Here she comes. Beautiful, beautiful. Of course, we're gonna want to have all sorts of things put in here. I mean, abyssalite also wouldn't go amiss, as it looks like we've been digging little bits down. No power at the moment. There we go. Beautiful. So now all sorts of things should happen. It's not the worst view, but it's not quite where I wanted to get to. I'm just gonna be like, hey, could you put everything in there? Okay, so this placement is a little bit better. Let's deconstruct this and move some wires around. But we are getting there. Good. 10 cycles left. That's also good. Still preserved the vacuum in there as well. This is great. This is all sorts great. Okay, that's good reach. That is good reach. You're going to get this next bit over here. I'm not sure how we're going to do the next one, though. I mean, we're not going to be going in from this angle. I'll tell you that. I wonder whether we want to put this tile back. that tooltip is not helpful, but unfortunately it looks like I can't actually get to where look at that. That would do it. If I could build it inside the blocks, hey? Over here, down here. I mean, they're not the worst points of view, but none of them seem to get where I need to be. And that is a lot of igneous rock, but I guess it's kind of going to have to stay. That's not great. On a scale of 1 to pretty messed up, I would say we have got boiling steam everywhere. So the problem that's going on at the moment is we've got water still sploshing out here. It's just the water we've had left over from emptying out the pipes. And it comes along and hits like this granite that's still at 117 degrees. We've got almost everything is over 100 degrees here. The thermal aqua tuna over 100 degrees. So we're just waiting for all the gases to just escape. And it turns out that's taking forever. Every now and then I send people in to try and rip this all apart at the highest priority, and now I'm building an extra triage cot. By the power of Reuben's sacrifice, and we really are like, we're letting her starve and stuff like this, we're getting some of the water to actually drain out of this system, mainly so I can start pumping crude oil again, because that's where we went wrong. We were too busy pumping polluted water to actually be able to move any crude around. Took me far too long to just be like, hey, why don't I just throw some generators down and use the ridiculous amounts of coal I've got? Who's scolding? I bet it's Curie. She's up here digging everything out. Putting in 2 thermal aqua tuners, because it seems a bit of a waste to not make use of that now. You know, we've got a lot of room. The next thing I need to do, of course, is to get a gas pump also made of... Oh, where's all my steel gone? That's where all my steel's gone. Oh, reversely in place of wonder. You're missing lime. I mean, yeah, that makes sense. We make a bunch of tungsten. I'm going to make a bunch of tungsten and send that across. That might be the way. It's not something that I can build out of, but I can then replace a bunch of my steel... Look, there's... Oh, there's glass. A bunch of my steel wirings or whatever with tungsten. I don't even know if we've got that. If I come over to the materials overlay and be like, hey, metals, what do we have that's made out of steel that, like look at that conductive wire there. I mean, that doesn't even need... That's just weird. Okay, we managed to save enough to just build one little gas pump in there. That's pretty much all I want, to be honest. That tells me that I want to have a floor there, and then I can build, though I can't at the moment, but I will be able to build this. Am I missing plastic? Don't tell me I'm missing. I've sent it all across to the other planet. That's why. So we will send a bunch of plastic back. Of course, it could be in here. No, it's not here yet. Actually, I have not made much out of steel. I mean, that makes sense, but Oh man, the overhaul has taken a little bit of time here, but we finally managed to get the box set up with two different aqua tuners in there, a gas pump ready to go. In fact, what I need to do is start clearing out some of the random gases that we have in here. I have gone and not connected this pipe up properly. I'm actually going to do it this way and then just cancel that so we don't rebuild anything over the top of stuff. Flip this switch and we should be able to get all of this out. If I just put the gas overlay on instead, we should be able to see this ticking over quite nicely. Now, almost all the gases are just being thrown out into the general waste stream. I'm fine with that. I've got no problems with that whatsoever. We're just going to be pumping this out until we've got a nice clean vacuum. And then we're going to pump a bit more water in there. At the moment, we've got 4 kilograms per tile. I think I want 10. I think that would be nice. That would give us 60 kilograms of water in the whole system. That might be a bit much. 1, 2, 3, 4. Again, there's 24 tiles in here at 60 kilograms for the whole lot. I'm going to work that out to about 2.5 kilograms per tile. I've just noticed that we are near enough out of food, but this shouldn't be too much problem. Maybe over on Reversaling, we've got some barbecue we can send over. Not too much, of course, because then we'd be taking away our own food. But with the power situation being what it is on Pyaxlin, though we have now got that sorted and the petroleum generator is ticking over, we're just trying to cool the place back down because all our bristle blossoms here are, I mean, they're 16 degrees over, something like that, so we need to bring this back into equilibrium. But of course we can at any moment kill some slicksters and get ourselves some food. Yeah, the bottleneck right now, very much the pumping of the gases. That's a bit of a shame because we're nearly ready to go. Of course, it's only after I've pulled a vacuum that I realized that I am missing a piece of automation from in there. If we come and have a look at the atmosphere sensor, I want this. I want to be able to put this somewhere and drag an output out to be able to put extra gases in, extra water in there as and when that is necessary. So we're going to have to pull a little line out here. Put a little automation bridge over the top and just go and bust a hole back in the side. That unfortunately a thing that needs to happen. Maybe Curie will be the person to come along and do it for us. I'm going to watch the overlay here. Let's watch our perfectly pulled vacuum get destroyed. What is this? What is this? All right, that's fine. I just want this done. Go. Okay, let's try that whole vacuum thing again, shall we? Let's see if we can pull this off a little bit better this time, as soon as that last tile gets put into place. Okay, this shouldn't take too long now, because the gases that are going through are unimpeded by the flow from down here. Though, that is also a little bit worrying. Why don't we have a good flow going? Because we're waiting for the natural gas to be burnt off. That's a good reason. All right, the oxygen is clear. I think the thing that we're going to do now is turn this gas pump off and maybe even split this here. This is now our steam outport. This is where we're going to be getting steam from now on. It might not even just be going to this one rocket. I can see us having another one here as well, which means we've got to move the oxygen. But first, before we do that, let's start turning this over. This currently is if above 14 degrees. That is right. Wait, let me see what's going wrong here. No, send signal if above 14 degrees. Of course, we need it to be above 14 degrees. This fires up the aqua tuner, which then starts warming up both the water down below and this lump of granite that we seem to have left there. But more importantly, it's warming up the thermal aqua tuner, hopefully up to triple digits. This can take a little bit of time. We are aware of that. And then when all this vaporizes up into steam, the thing I want to do is then set this atmosphere sensor up to start pouring more water in as and when we need it. If we don't need it, then we don't need it. But if we do need it, I want it. Why are we slightly over... I'm just gonna hope that everything won't fire up at once. Yes, I'm gonna hope. That's definitely the way to go about doing this. Okay, so our current ambient pressure is half a kilogram. Let's say I want to have a kilogram, and if below, please add more water, which won't until this last bit of wire gets put in place. I was kind of hoping, actually, that the rest of these water tiles would melt before that happens. Let's switch back to above for now, because I've got a feeling this is going to turn over to more than a kilo very, very shortly. And at that point, I actually want to flick the switch up down to below and see if anything, see if that's a good way to keep it topped up. I'm just watching the temperature of this thermal aqua tuna. I would really like it to also go above 100 degrees. Okay, I'm just going to flick that switch now. We don't need that much more water put into here. More water is going into the system. Hopefully, it's not going to cool things down too much. Okay, seems to be good. The steam turbine up here won't turn on when we go over 200 degrees. That is for a little bit of efficiency for the power draw. It will fill up all the way rather than when it just turns on at 125, where it only gives us like 300 watts or something like that. I'm going to try my best, because I want to put down this gas reservoir down here, to try and not let this glossy Draco loose. I've got a feeling if he gets out into the wild and we end up having to put him over here, we're gonna kill it. Like that, let's be honest. The glossy Dracos are kind of, well, I mean, they're not kind of rare, but I rarely see them. So, okay, I've convinced the pipes that the flow is real. We've not got this gas reservoir set up, though, so I'm not sure quite how it's figured that one out, but I mean, I will go with it. There should be some sort of flow in. The polluted oxygen will flow away. This will go over the gas bridge, and it's got nowhere to go after the gas bridge, so it doesn't know what to do. Okay, that's fine. Okay, and once the pipe is... what's gone wrong? Why aren't we just pumping on? Look, this doesn't have a gas pipe behind it. Guess we'll just try and get that done quick. I thought the whole system had broken there for a second. I was really disappointed, but no, it looks like all we need is that one little pipe in yes, okay, cool. Well, all we needed was that one little pipe in place, and everything works out well. I'm not going to be sure how well it's doing until this tank fills up with oxygen, which is very far into the future. Yeah, very far into the future. But given what I can see, I think we're good. This will go up, jump over, and into this tank over here. We'll just put in the pipes for it. There's a lot of bridges jumping around here, but that's just to make sure that the priority queues are set up correctly. So it should be fine. Of course, now tidying up all our mess is quite a high priority as well. Okay, with this last piece of piping, we should start to see some oxygen flow towards the rocket over here. And I do believe, let's just give it a little bit of a test. If we flick this switch on and then turn it back off, what's actually going to happen is a lot of these are going to cool down the steam because it's fresh pipe, which hasn't actually had enough time to warm up to its surroundings. But actually looks like we're going to be fine all of the way. Look at that. How's that for an infrastructure upgrade? I am loving it. How's the drill cone research going, though? Because this is what we're really waiting for. It's going. It is actually going. So over here, we're awaiting radbolts. And we're out of data banks. Oh, that is a shame. I thought we had enough data banks over here for some more than we did. Data bank, 2 units available out of 0. We're going to have to send Plank back up, which is good timing, because we've just got this whole interior ready for him. Maybe we could do with a fridge here. I've just noticed that we don't have a refrigeration unit, and I got a feeling he'd be very happy with one. So we're having a little bit of a crisis right now, but you know, when is that ever not the norm? We've got ourselves a bunch of meat to be going through, but we are starting to run out of slicksters. We had 40 when I started this whole process. I'm now down to less than 20. A little bit worried about that. And the thing that is holding us back is the fact that the temperature on here is not dropping fast enough. It is dropping, don't get me wrong, but we have been tens of cycles now and we're still not below 30. So I have gone around and prepared a bunch of bypasses, and I think I'm gonna do, if it will actually allow me to do this, is to break this off into a smaller unit, a much, much smaller unit. Then what I'm going to do is fire up this secondary unit over here, which I still haven't put the power down for. Let's change that really quickly, shall we? And hopefully this secondary unit will be able to just keep this area cool. That's all I want it to do, is just cool down that area, maybe keep the corridor cool as well. Right, have we hit the... Oh, there's always a backwards bridge somewhere. The rare case of the red alert. Okay, that's all right. We can deal with this. Hopefully someone's also going around and dealing with the power systems. That would also work out quite well. So we want to go white to green, of course. That is the way that it goes around. Maxwell, not the fastest at actually digging. People over here doing some work. Good old Curie all about it. Maxwell really takes his time to dig. So, we've almost segregated this unit off. To be able to change that, though, we want to be able to segregate this unit as well. Hopefully, this will just now start flowing up and through. There's no power running through, but because of the way that the bridges are all set up, this should be fine and just carries on its way around. Okay, so the next thing that is the problem is the fact that we've just got, like, a massive backlog here. I want to cut this right there. Do we start getting movement, or have I got too much in there? Yeah, just a little bit too much in there. Let's drop one of those somewhere. Empty pipe contents. Thankfully, I do have a duplicate who can do that. And I believe I just want to put those across there. And that should be it? Question mark. I think this now gets us all rolling. There should maybe a little bit of a gap in that, but that's fine. We can correct that as we go. We can start like stripping down extraneous pipes, which is something that I sometimes forget to do, but there we go. Beautiful. Still waiting for someone to come across and do this. Who is in charge? Franklin. Beautiful. Okay, so that's now this loop down and chilling. Hopefully this will bring the water down in temperature incredibly fast. Of course, we are coming through this hot bit. This may have been the biggest problem of my system here coming down. This was 60 degree water. It's now just 57 degree water. Then it goes round and dumps all its heat through the aqua tuner. Okay, that's good. And then this one should hopefully be going down even faster as long as the wires are being made. Okay, last wire in place. This should now start leading to some chill water. We're going out at 33, coming in at 33, going out at 20. That should be pretty cool. It keeps holding up. Why, what's up? What's up? I don't see any reason to hold it. Ah, it's because we are destroying some pipe. It took a little bit of time, but here we go. We've got some of our bristle blossoms growing again. These ones out here not doing so well. Is that because the door's hot? It might be because the door is hot. I noticed that I've got a little bit of lead on the floor, though. So maybe what I'm going to do is go along and turn the door into a chill section. I think that would work out quite nicely. But whilst we watch Plant go around and do the day-to-day chores in the base, whilst he can't be a scientist, I would like to take this moment right here and thank the people helping me with my day-to-day life when I can't be a scientist. That's right, scrolling up the screen right now, you will see a list of names. These people are my patrons. These are the guys and girls that have taken the time out of their day and the money out of their wallets to head on over to patreon.com/twitchy and say that my channel could do with some money to keep moving forward into the future. This money is covering my electric and PC upgrades, so I really do, from the very bottom of my heart, have to say thank you. So very much, guys. Along with all the other issues that we had, the natural gas geyser had actually gone dormant. Thankfully, we are now back up and running with that. We probably should have gone in and grabbed all of the equipment out of there. But that means that we're not going to be draining quite so hard on our oil reserves as we were. Like, we've really actually got to the point where we're starting to scrape the very bottom of the barrel. In fact, we don't have any oil, any petroleum coming through at the moment. So we're pretty much surviving now on the natural gas geyser until this oil well can turn over. Oh, and of course the coal generator, which I was going to do this too. I was going to do rip this one down, drop that tile down one, and then build another coal generator just over here, apart from we don't have enough steel or tungsten. But if I hold on just a moment, some should get delivered to us. But one thing you may have noticed in the background is I have been running off a whole bunch of plastic up into the rocket here. One thing that I've discovered is that actually the barracks don't care that you've got the orbital data collection lab in there. If I wasn't so particular about the radiation, I could think about putting a comfy bed up there instead of the ladder bed, but no, we're not going to do that. Okay, I am going to change this from... I'm just going to change the destination. That's what I'm going to do here. I'm going to move over in this rough direction because we've got a tile over there and a tile up there that we could be picking up with the telescope. And Plank, are you part of the crew? Let's have a look. Plank is not marked down as crew. There we go. We'll put Plank down as the crew and ask for all crew to indeed come towards. We don't really have a great deal of oxygen on board, and we don't have a great deal of solar panel coming in, but we're going to see what we can do. We're going to see what we can do. Hopefully we can now begin the launch sequence, and we should be able just to watch this take off nicely. I was surprised that it told me that it was all good. There was not an acknowledge warnings that I had to click to take this guy off. Is that a little carbon dioxide canister down there? I did not know. I was not aware. Okay, so as we are off into orbit, let's see what Plank is up to here. He should just be going. Oh, this has not been queued up forever. But of course, there's this as well. Why did he not do this? Plank should actually be quite proficient with that. That's not quite where I wanted to be. Let's go back to view the interior here. Is it because it's a lower priority, or is it just the one that he happened to pick first? No, just not able to do it at all. Let's check his skills. Maybe he doesn't have the skills to be able to do it, but that would very much catch me by surprise. I mean, surely the astronomy, yeah, telescope usage. Yeah, this should. Why not? Why aren't you doing this? What is wrong? Let's pump the priority up and see if we can get Plank to get into there. Wait, can Plank actually get in there? That might be a thing. Let's move to... Yeah, no reason why not. Let's move him over. We got power. Maybe we don't have enough power. No, if that's running, then surely this is running. 60, 120. Yeah, I'm not sure. Whilst Plank drifts round in orbit above Pi accident here, turning his hard-earned plastic into... Let's go back into here. Into data research modules, so we can turn that into actual science for later. I am going to have to look down at the red bar below and notice that it is coming all the way to the end here, so I can say thank you very much for joining me for this adventure, ladies and gentlemen. I will see you guys next time. Well, we've got a few things to sort out, but we are starting to expand out. I want to find out what's going on with the telescope, and maybe if I can actually get round to it, build ourselves another rocket platform. Oh, hello, what are you doing here? Another rocket platform so that we can start sending off some rover modules. But I will see you then, or when we're gonna do that. Bye.